You can feel the energy in this building. They are fired up for game one. Back with that after this. And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. The show presents the National League Division Series. It's the Arizona Diamondbacks taking on the Los Angeles Dodgers. John Shambi on play-by-play. Chris Singleton providing the color. Game one is always critical in a postseason series, Singy.
Yeah, and this is when you love having home field advantage, Boog. If you capture game one, you're full of confidence that you've got a chance to ride that momentum for the rest of the series.
And on the visiting side, starting pitching is always the big key in a game like this to kick off a series.
Yeah, you need a strong performance on the mound. That's the number one way to cancel out the home field edge we just mentioned.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set, Clayton Kershaw getting the start.
Yeah, Boog, when you're a teammate of a guy like this, you love when it's his turn to pitch. He's out there on the mound carrying himself with a ton of confidence. That gives other guys confidence that, hey, the other team's not going to score much. All we've got to do is have good at-bats, put up some runs, and we should be able to get a win. He's got some of the best stuff around the league. So if he's on, he has the ability to control the game, and guys aren't really going to get much to hit.
Ready to go? Stepping in, Jake McCarthy. On the ground, right side. Steps on first for the out. Time to take a look at the Diamondbacks lineup. They're dealing with a top-level arm on the mound, so this figures to be a tough matchup for them. What's the key to the offense today, Singy?
Oh, Boog, I think when you got a guy that's this talented on the mound, you got to find ways to disrupt his rhythm, make him uncomfortable a little bit. The guys that can handle the bat and perhaps, you know, bunt for a base hit, get him moving off the mound. If you're in the box and he seems to be just in a flow, step out, mess up his timing, somehow try to get in his head a little bit. And then when he does come in the zone, you may only get one pitch. You better not miss it.
To third, Muncy. Whips it across. Quick start here this evening. Two out. Top of the first. This is Corbin Carroll. He's a left-handed batter who still comes up with good contact and a good average against left-handed pitchers. And Singy, as a team, you need to make the most of the very few opportunities he's going to give you. This one swung on and hit well. Way back there. And that one's gone. He powers one out to right field, and the D-backs jump out in front. It's 1-0.
Well, you can see he was out front just a little bit. Maybe didn't recognize the changeup earlier, but he got the bat head to it, hooked it down the line, and was able to keep it fair for a long home run. Really impressive.
And now it's Christian Walker. And a swing and a miss. That's out number three. D-backs get one on the solo jack. It's now 1-0. This is the National League Division Series on the show. Back here at Dodger Stadium. And on the mound now, Merrill Kelly. Lots of punch-outs. A real strikeout artist, Singy.
Yeah, Bogey got the win last time out, worked deep into the ball game and scattered a couple of hits. You can expect him today to try to match that performance of his last time out.
And at the plate for the Dodgers, Ahmed Rosario. The 1-1 is fouled off. And a 1-2. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Tell you what, those are the types of guys pitchers really like to punch out when they're on the mound, because if they get on, just the distraction that they create with all that speed over on the base pass, it could take away your focus from the next hitter, and that's the last thing you want to do is serve up a pitch that a guy hits over the fence, and it's a multi-run home run.
And the batter now, James Outman. Next offering is fouled back. Next one misses, and the count is even, 2-2.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten out.
Boots it.
Well, it looked like a pretty routine play. Just couldn't get it to stick in the glove as he gets tagged with the error. Should have been two outs in the inning, but now they have to work around it and get two more.
Here's Mookie Betts. The 1-1. Comes up empty. That's strike two. One, two, bottom of the first. The pitch. Inside, just missed.
It's a good take.
Kelly moved to first. Outman back in on a dive. Righty to the plate. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Two out.
Well, that at-bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there. At least to foul something off, extend that at-bat.
Freddie Freeman up to the dish. Throw to first, and he's back safely. Back over to first. Yeah, they're keeping him close. Next pitch misses inside, and the count's even at two. Outman leads off first with two down to the inning. Swings through it for the K. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. One error in the inning, but it doesn't hurt him. On to the second now from Dodger Stadium. It's the Diamondbacks 1 and the Dodgers nothing. Back here in L.A., here's Ketel Marte. Swing and a miss. 1-2.
Sometimes a hitter will go up there and guess, and it's not just pulling something out of the sky, but expecting because of tendencies a certain pitch in a certain location. He just guessed wrong.
Kershaw fires. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Couldn't catch up to the heater. Here's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. Ball to strike. The pitch. Late that time, and it's strike two. And a 1-2. Started to go after it. Now a look down to first. Did not go. 2-2 now. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. The wind and the pitch. On the ground to third. Whips it to first. Two up, two down at the top of the second.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got the ground ball.
Now it's Evan Longoria's turn. And now the lefty Bounced up the middle. Fires over to first. Longoria retired. And that is the third out of the inning. So they go quietly there. We go to the bottom of inning number two. It's the Diamondbacks one and the Dodgers nothing. And welcome back. Now J.D. Martinez at the plate.
No left fielder.
J.D. Martinez is the first guy that I remember seeing videotaping his own batting practice so that he could go back inside and look at the video. And a pitch. Good eye right there.
Two balls, one strike.
Tries to hold up, appeal to first, and he held up. Three and one, Martinez waits. And he walked him.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
The batter now will be Will Smith. The 1-1 is fouled off.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
Here's a 1-2. And a swing and a miss. That's one out, the bottom of the second. Max Muncy at the dish. This guy with light tower power. Left-hand hitter waits. That misses off the outside edge. Swing and a miss as he was late that time. James Kingsley, our plate umpire, consistent and maybe a little generous on the edges.
Yeah, Boog, he'll give a little bit on the edges, like you said, but from what I've seen, he usually does that when a guy is just commanding those parts of the strike zone, and essentially the guy's earned it, the umpire rolls with him.
The punch out there, back-to-back strikeouts.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed, it's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Here's Jason Hayward. Next offering is in for a strike. Swing and a high fly ball left field. Carroll moving under it. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And that is that. No runs, no base hits, no errors, and a runner left. We head on down to the top of the third. It's the Diamondbacks one and the Dodgers nothing. Back here at Chavez Ravine. And here's the catcher, Gabriel Moreno. The why to kick the pitch. This one popped up. Hernandez makes the grab, one away. Next up for the Diamondbacks, Jordan Lawler. One down, base is empty. Misses off the plate, and it's 2-1. And delivers outside. The 3-1. Gets the outside corner with that one.
Man, that pitch was dotted. So much talent on display when this guy's out there on the hill.
In the air to left, down the line. tries to make the play, but it's foul.
Oh, he's ready for that fastball right there. Really turned on it, hit it hard, had the distance, but just too much hook to it. So might want to make a little bit of an adjustment, let it travel a little more, and see if you can keep that thing fair. Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
And now the right fielder, Jake McCarthy. He's 0 for 1. Flips the corner and a count 1-2.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
In the dirt. Smith gathers, throws. That completes the strikeout, and that'll do it. Welcome back as we go to the last of the third. Here's Kike Hernandez. And now two balls and a strike.
2-1.
And that one clips the corner. The wind of the pitch. Good eye right there. On the ground, Marte. Over to first. Leadoff man retired here in the third.
Now batting, the shortstop, Ahmed
Rosario. And now it's Ahmed Rosario. The wind of the pitch. That's in there. That's strike two. That one is upstairs.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And a pitch. Out towards left center. Pham drifts towards it. Puts it away for the out.
The center fielder, number 33, James.
And next for L.A., James Outman. He's 0 for 1. That misses the zone. 2-1. Swing and a miss as he was late.
This batter has to understand his job is to get on base however he can. If he gets hit by a pitch, if he walks, maybe even singles. But you want to get the heart of the order up to the plate.
The next offering misses, and that's ball three.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
And here it comes. Got it by him for the K.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
Back here at Dodger Stadium, start of the fourth, and now the center fielder, Tommy Pham.
Tommy Pham.
Kershaw to 2-1. And it's fouled away.
Well, these Diamondbacks doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of him. He's only given up one run, but the starter's pitch count is starting to get up there. And that might be the best news yet for this offense.
Got him swinging.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
Two on now. Popped up to the left into foul ground. Muncy pulls that one down, and there's two down.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Christian Walker stands in now for the Diamondbacks. went down on strikes his first time through. The 1-2. And a ball evens the count.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Now all even up. Just missed. Ketel Marte on deck for Arizona. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Close pitch there, but you got to forget about that call if you're out on the mound. You can't let it affect you going forward. You've got to get out of the inning first, and then if you want to be frustrated, take it out in the dugout.
Walker, the runner at first with two gone. Pitch misses. Two balls and a strike. Kicks and fires. Swing and a pop-up. Foul out of play off to the right side. That'll find the stands.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
The 2-2 on the way. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Brings it in for the third out. So no runs on no hits, no errors, and one left on. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the Diamondbacks 1 and the Dodgers nothing. Back here at the ballpark, Mookie Betts will get us started.
The designated hitter.
Chris, you know, it's a little known fact. Mookie Betts' uncle was Terry Shumpert, who played 14 years in the big leagues. Pitches in for a strike, and the count is 1-2.
Yeah, Shump spending time with the Royals, Red Sox, Cubs, Padres, Rockies, and Tampa Bay Rays.
Next pitch misses inside, and that's ball two. And a pitch. Swing and a line drive, slicing into right field. McCarthy hauls it in, and there's one away.
The first baseman, number 5.
Freddie. Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit. Freeman. His first at bat was a strikeout. And the righty deals. Now a pop-up on the infield. Marte makes the grab, and there's two gone.
Now batting, left fielder, J.D.
And here is J.D. Martinez. He reached out a walk his first time. Righty delivers. Liner, base hit. So the inning is still alive with Will Smith coming to the dish.
He was all over that one. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
And up to the plate is Will Smith. 0 for 1, he struck out swinging last time. Next offering is downstairs. Kicks and deals. On the ground to the left. That's the third out. Inning over. So no runs here on a base hit. No errors and one left. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's the Diamondbacks 1 and the Dodgers nothing. Back here in L.A., top five, John Schombe with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Lourdes Gurriel Jr. The pitch. Falling behind 2-1. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Grabs it on the run. And there's one away.
That was a good, hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop-up and an easy out for the defense.
That one ran inside, almost got him.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count, be ready to turn on a fastball.
That catches the top part of the zone. 3-2 now. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Next offering is fouled back. Pitch. And that's ball four.
When you go that deep into an at bat, the hitter usually comes out on top.
Man at first with one gone. Next to hit for Arizona, Gabriel Moreno. 0-1 so far. The pitch. And there he goes. The 1-1 is fouled off. Longoria leads off first with one away. That's off the mark. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Squirts away a little bit.
I got to think that was the plan all the way. He set him up with a high fastball and then bury that curveball down low to get him swinging. Now, especially with how effective pitchers work up in the zone these days, that's a devastating combination.
Jordan Lawler stands in now for the Diamondbacks. And a 1-1. Slice the other way. That's a base hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. 2 on and 2 out.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
And now, Jake McCarthy. And he grounds one back up the middle. That's the third out. Nice grab. No runs, a hit, 2 left. Last half of the fifth coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 1 and the Dodgers nothing. We head to the bottom of the fifth. And now Max Muncy. He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the 3 true outcomes category.
Well, we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slug is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns.
fastball almost got him there.
Now in this three ball count, down in the ball game, you've got to be very selective. Take your walk if they'll give it to you.
Swing and a miss, and it's a full count now. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. No outs, runner at first. And up next for Los Angeles, Jason Hayward. 0-for-1 with a flyout. Left-hand batter waits. And a count 1-2. And the right-hander deals.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Pulled the string on the changeup. Enrique Hernandez steps to the plate for the Dodgers. 0-for-1, he grounded out in his first at bat. Lifted in the air down the left side. Lawler makes the grab, two down.
Now batting, shortstop, Ahmed Rosario.
So up next, Ahmed Rosario. Ball and a strike. And a changeup clips the zone for a strike.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
On a line out towards center. Coming on is Pham to make the play. And that is the inning. So the Dodgers leave one. They're down 1-0. Welcome back. Here's Tommy Pham. Here's a 1-1. Curveball over for a called strike. The pitch. The Dodgers bullpen with some action. Ryan Brazier preparing to come on if needed. Vesia, a left-hander, also throwing. Swing and a high fly ball, pretty well struck right field. And it hits the fence. And that's a double.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Showed off some really nice oppo pop with that swing and just couldn't get it over the fence. But I absolutely love everything about that approach and the mechanics right there.
Here's the left fielder, Corbin Carroll. His homer earlier is responsible for the only runs they've scored in this one.
Yeah, forget small ball. They're kind of living and dying by the long ball so far in this one. Well, just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
That hits the dirt, 2-2. and a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away.
The first baseman, Christian Walker.
Here's a big power threat. Christian Walker. That one's in there. And the count, 1-2. And it's second. And now 2-2. Rolled over to third, Muncy. On to first, two away.
The batter at third, second baseman, Ketel.
Ketel Marte up to the plate. Two outs and one in scoring position. Intentional walk here with two out. They set up a force at any base to end the inning.
Now that designated hitter.
It appears Dave Roberts is going to dig into his bullpen as he comes out of the dugout to make the change. Kershaw will depart, and the line not closed on him yet as he's responsible for the runners on base. Back with a new pitcher after this. Now a right-handed arm out of the bullpen, Yency Almonte.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
And it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. Here's a 1-1. This one chopped up the middle. They take the force out, and that's terrific work out of the bullpen. One pitch to end the frame. Excellent work out of the Dodgers bullpen there. 2-3-4 due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Diamondbacks 1, and the Dodgers nothing. Bottom of the sixth inning, and stepping in is the speedy James Outman. The 1-1. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. And there's one away.
Now back, the designated hitter, Mookie.
Now it's Mookie Betts. He has, as they like to say, light tower power. Not a big guy, but a big swing and thunder in that bat. 1-1 now.
Two balls, one strike.
Just missed. Chris, one of the things about Mookie, he really hits the outside pitch well.
Well, pitchers know he can hit the outside pitch so well that now as a pitcher, you have to throw it off the plate away. And if he's got good plate discipline, you find yourself falling behind in the count and walking batters. It feels to me like his time on the mound is running short, starting to show some signs of fatigue. So we'll see how much longer they let him go.
One run game, one out, one on. In the air, out towards left center. That skips over the fence, so it's an automatic double.
Off the bat, I thought they were going to score their first run of the game, and that feels like a tough break. But look at the bright side. Really good contact at the plate, and now they're working with not just one, but two runners in scoring position. So they'd love another base hit right here.
So two in scoring position with one out. Now it's J.D. Martinez. The next pitch misses. Ball two. That clips a corner.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Betts at third. Freeman over at second with one down. Misses inside, and it's 3-2. Will Smith waiting for a turn at the plate. There's ball four.
He knew he had a little wiggle room with the open base, but now that disappears. Mistake to this next batter, and this inning might really break open.
Will Smith steps to the plate for the Dodgers. The 2-2. And a swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there.
Well, this is where the team aspect really comes into play on the offensive side of the game, right? I mean, missed opportunity to tie it up with the runner at third, one out, couldn't put the ball in play. So now it's time to pick him up. And that's where good teams, they go to. They operate on this level of next man up. That mentality is what causes them to win series, get into the postseason. That helps keep the energy and morale high in the dugout.
Just misses with that one. Bases loaded, two down. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. All loaded up, dangerous hitter at the plate. And that's outside.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there. Like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
That one misses, and that'll bring home a run.
He's really gotten himself into a mess out there and now forces home a run with the walk. This inning's definitely getting away from him.
Here comes the manager out of the dugout, and he'll make a move for the bullpen. Merrill Kelly out of the game, and that was a start he can feel pretty good about. Tie ball game, and new pitcher when we get back. So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, Joe Mantiply.
Bringing in the lefty with the left-handed hitter coming up to hit. Classic bullpen move right here, so we'll see how it works out.
So two down. Now it's the right fielder, Jason Hayward. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
It's a 1-1. And a swing and a miss.
Both starters out of this ball game. It now becomes a battle of the bullpens and just seeing which manager can match up better and who's able to get to the finish line.
1-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out. So they get one, but end up leaving the bases loaded. On to the seventh here in game one. All tied 1-1. Back here at Chavez Ravine, top of inning number seven, down to third baseman, Evan Longoria. The pitch. Bounce to the left side. Muncy sends to first. Longoria retired.
The catcher, number 14, Gabriel Moreno.
And now the catcher comes up to him. Gabriel Moreno. The 1-1. That one back up the middle and it gets through.
Just kept it simple. Played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
And now the shortstop, Jordan Lawler, 1-2. Here comes a pitch. Fouled off. He was late.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base. Try to stay out of a double play here.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And now the count filled up 3-2. Jake McCarthy waiting to hit for the D-backs. One away. Tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. Got him. That's the second out. So back to the top of the Arizona lineup. Jake McCarthy stands in now for the Diamondbacks. The 2-1. Next offering misses down and away. Tommy Pham to bat next. Righty to the plate. There's the strike up high. Now 3-2.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. And that moves the go-ahead run to scoring position with two gone.
Well, that worked out as good as it could have. We mentioned the RBI opportunity with the runner moving on the 3-2 pitch. And he cashed in by finding a hole in the outfield. You know, that takes a little extra concentration in the box because of the movement on the base paths. Easy to get distracted, so that was a really nice job there.
Next to hit, Tommy Pham. In the air, left field, down the line. Martinez has a beat on it, and that will end the inning. A couple of hits in the inning, but they can't get him home. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. All tied, 1-1. Set for the last half of the 7th, and at the plate for the Dodgers, Enrique Hernandez. Hit on the ground to the right side, and that's just foul. And a ball and two strikes. Hit softly on the ground left side. Longoria to first. They go 5-3 for the first out as the third baseman makes the play from the shortstop spot in the shift. Ahmed Rosario steps to the plate for the Dodgers. So now 1-2.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
And a pitch. And now the count is even. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That's out number 2. So two down now, and here is James Outman. And a payoff pitch. That one to first. Walker takes it himself. That ends the inning. Dodgers down in order. Score remains deadlocked at one. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Ryan Brazier.
Number 57, Ryan.
Now the left fielder, Corbin Carroll. He's already homered in this game.
Now this guy, a player that, if he gets on base, has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Left-hand hitter waits. See the velocity, 97 with that fastball. Christian Walker. Up next. Right through there. Got it. Important first out to begin the eighth.
Frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Christian Walker will hit next. The 1-1. There's a strike. Got him swinging for the K. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. He's having fun at bats if you're a hitter. I'm so glad I'm retired.
And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Ketel Marte. And he deals in there. And so now 1-2. One missed. High in the air, out to right. Hayward has this one sized up. He's got it. And that is out number three. And the Diamondbacks down in order. Score remains tied 1-1. Ready for the bottom of the eighth, and now the DH, Mookie Betts.
He's a big, strong guy, can untie this game with one swing.
That misses, and it's 2-1. In there at the knees. That's down and in. Freddie Freeman waits on deck. Three, two. Out to short, Lawler. Rolls across the diamond, and Betts is gone.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground, nice ground out.
Freddie Freeman steps to the plate for the Dodgers. 1-3. And a pitch. Down front, pulls that one foul. Now it's 3-2. At the belt and fires. Chopped to first. And he takes it himself for the out.
Now batter, left fielder, J.D. Martinez.
Here is J.D. Martinez.
Oh, look out here. He's going to come up ready to swing in this situation.
2-1 to JD. Swings through that.
2-2.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
The 2-2. Upstairs.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
On the ground, and it goes just foul. Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. Struck him out looking. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. We're on to the ninth in game one. All tied 1-1. All set to start the ninth in this one. Now it's the DH, Lourdes Gurriel Jr. And the righty deals. That just misses. 2 balls, 2 strikes.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Kicks and fires. In the air, right field. Hayward makes the play, and there's one down. Evan Longoria stands in now for the Diamondbacks. And a 2-1 on the way. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Righty delivers. And now it's 3-2. Gabriel Moreno in the on-deck circle. Got him! Now 2 away. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get outs. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
Gabriel Moreno stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Here's a 2-1. And strike two. Here's a 2-2. To the right side. And foul ball. And here it comes. Base hit, center field. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
So a lefty out of the pen, Alex Vesia.
Number 51, Alex.
And the batter will be the shortstop, Jordan Lawler. And a 1-1. And downstairs. The 2-1. That one is absolutely belted. Way back there, it's got a chance. And it's off the wall. In to score from first. And a 2-1 ball game now.
Well, he gets it done in a big spot to get the run across. This was a really nice swing. Didn't quite get enough behind it to get it out of here, but once it got over his head in left field, it was extra bases all the way.
And now the right fielder, Jake McCarthy.
Showed a really nice opposite field approach in his last at bat.
Drilled in the air, right field, way back there, and that is out of here. With one swing, he quiets the crowd, and they add to their lead. It's 4-1.
For a pitcher, the odds are in your favor if you keep that breaking ball down. That time, he got punished for it. Hitter just did a really good job of staying within himself and getting the barrel to the baseball.
So two away with nobody on. And now here is Tommy Pham. Two outs.
Inside, ball two.
On the corner at the knees for a strike.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back in there to try to finish you off.
2-2. And that one hit 97 on the gun. D-backs add a pair on the homer. It's now 4-1. You're watching the National League Division Series on the show. Paul Sewald taking over on the mound.
And I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at-bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
And at the plate for the Dodgers, Will Smith.
The catcher, Will Smith.
Good eye in that spot. The pitch. Slapped foul. The pitch. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, I definitely say that's a statement strikeout right there. You come out of the bullpen, go right after the hitters, and three pitches later, you got one out. Tell you what, if you're in the dugout, you're looking at each other and saying, he's going to be tough to get to today.
The 2-1. Good eye right there. The pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. And that's a strikeout looking. Throws him with a backdoor slider.
Well, it's kind of tough right here. Closer comes in and he strikes out the first two hitters. It's hard not to feel defeated, and then this is going to go quickly. But you got to go up there, maybe try to find a way to choke up on the bat, spread out, put the ball in play, and maybe you can extend this inning.
And they're at the knees. And it's 1-2.
Pitching has been pretty dominant in this one, but you got to be careful. Not working with too big a lead. They could get right back in this ballgame if you're not careful.
Just one strike away. That's the third. Throw to first. Ball game. And the Diamondbacks claim the win here behind some great pitching and defense.
Winning never gets old, but it's also important to come out and play with some level of a fear of failure. That's what brings out the best, knowing that if I don't bring it today, we could lose. And nobody likes to lose, especially when you work this hard to play at this level. Nice win today.
So, Singy, as the numbers show, a great performance on the mound in this one.
Absolutely, and that really set the tone from the beginning. A fantastic effort.
4-1 the final here today. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
The final line score for the ball game tonight. First for the victorious Diamondbacks. 4 runs on 8 hits. 1 error. They left 7 men on base.